Still needing 10 yards. Second down. Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense.
Let's go!
Snap to get one. Now wins. He's got it. He's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play action pass, and completing it.
Set of downs here. Play number six on this drive.
Hurry up, here we go.
Detroit!
Let's go. Blue 90! Blue 90!
They just do get the playoff as he looked to throw. Got tipped, got threw everything off. It brings up third.
Anytime the ball's thrown over there, the field is popped up in the air. I expect someone to catch, no matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
It's been a seven-play opening drive, and this is third and short.
Situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
But they face a second and long to start things out. Is fielded in the end zone. Almost outkept his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. And possession will switch here as this offense will come on deep in their own territory. And tough starting field position here.
Fourth down.
They bring their punter out there now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Here's Jackson. Officially, there goes a 52-yard punt. Too short. And the offense will come back onto the field with first and 10. And here now the offense heading back out there. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it.
Bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue lining. Blue lining.
Now they'll throw it. Wins. And caught. That's a green. And down inside the 15. Shot.
Watch it now, Barney.
12 yards there as they move the chains. They're going to hurry back to the line now. So they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Right. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10.
Now let's go. Blue 90.
On second down, here's Woods. And he fires one.
think
you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling the right, making sure we ease into the game when it comes up. So you have that opportunity to
themselves in front, and now see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. And it's good to make it 7-0. Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and he'll bring the football out to the 25. So out now comes the offense back on the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They send Green to the left on his own. Wants to try again on second down. Trying to lay one up deep. Looking for Green and it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked up. Officially, it's called a 50-yard. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. Second and long. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he will take it back only to about the 13-yard line here. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect, but just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Come on, let's go! Brown!
The second half starts with a carry by Bell. And he'll be taken down at the 18. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground. Bell will make it 2nd and 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in the running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
At 4, we're going to get a timeout call. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this 3rd quarter. And the offense needs 7 out of this play on 3rd down. They'll come out in the pistol. And he's going to lose yards here back to the 12-yard line. Losing 40 yards that time, and now it's 4th down.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. With it is Jackson. And the 43-yard punt, but an edge is 33. They take over for the 1st and 10 on the short side of the field. They come out here on the
line. Boom, landed! Watching that Marty party!
They're trying to get the ground game going with Freeman. Pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
Detroit!
On 2nd down, and he is going to lose yardage here. They wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd down.
And that's another sack for the defense. Something we've seen all game long. They've been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
3 yards left to grab here on 3rd down. This is 4th and 14.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes in certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result is the same. Quarterback is hit.
Throwing now is Wentz. And a catch right side by Evans. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down on the 46.
get the sack. Hurry up, here we go.
But they have to either fight or either have a great play call, or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, that play typifies what we've seen from the offense all day long. They've had no success getting things going. I think for the offensive coordinator, he's got to go to that side of the play sheet that says, try something different. Try some specials, something that I haven't seen all day to try and get this offense kick-started.
Hurry up, here we go!
Now Wentz throwing on second down. He takes a shot on the release as this would be incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver, and it's third down. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one. Comes to the line now, first and 10. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. Jack Del Rio is going to take a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So the offense has it first and 10.
Hurry up, here we go.
He goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. Wentz. Flushed out right. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
Detroit!
He'll get a
Detroit!
Couple yards on that one. And it'll be third and 10.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback. But all day long, they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short game.
And now they're in the hurry. Conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, okay, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. Kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. This is taken near the 13. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And now back out comes the offense. And in the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They're going to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And at this stage in the game, every play is magnified here as we get down to the nitty-gritty.
Here we go!
They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. And he's going to cut it back up to him. Evades the tackle and now some space.
Terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. Tyreek Hill on the return. It'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
And leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense.
Look at me, Detroit!
Mason Green to the left is home. They go play action here on first down. Starting to run out, really becoming a factor. We'll see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back to the offense.
Let's go! Brad, 30
loss of 10. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Now from way back there after the sack, it's third and goal, a long third and goal.
Here we go! Grand 38!
They're going to look to throw. Now they go screen, it's complete. Good contain, their gain on the screen, and they'll bring up fourth down.
I bet you got a baseball backpack. You did some of that, right? What do they do when they do the signals? An indicator, right?
It's it goes or not, yeah.
Yeah, whether the play's on or not. I thought the indicator's offensive lineman good. When they're picking up last year on pass. We just saw that there, didn't we?
No game.
No game to separate and finish the play off.
Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And there's so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work.
All right, here we go. Blue landed!
Second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmakers.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator is looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play we're looking at. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's. That's exactly what they did there.
Kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. This is taken about 7 yards deep. They'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. So out now comes the offense back on the field. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to have a time that they play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage, you can either spike it and stop the clock, or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Back to Fairman, first down. Escaping the pressure. Escaping this time, it's him go down. They got him for a second. Whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. One receiver right, that's Jeffrey.
Here we go! Man, 38!
So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and one. Between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. This one fielded at the five. And get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Now this offense ready to take over again. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far.
Position. A lot of these guys in college, they're safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL. Those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. Yeah, that'll make it third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And the dreaded third and long here for the offense.
Travel someone who can help us, because I thought I was going to pass out at the end. Not just getting to the overtime, but the plays in overtime that led to this one, and to finish it on a defensive touchdown, a takeaway that gets into the end zone. I'm not rooting for anyone, but boy, I'd love to see games finish that way.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. This has been Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Join the discussion on Twitter at @EASports_MUT. With that, we say so long, everybody.